A good day to all. Today, I am going to narrate the story of Kalpana Saroj. From being a Dalit bride to owning $112 million worth company, let's see her story. Kalpana's father was a constable, so they lived in the police quarters. She had three sisters and two brothers. As they were Dalits, the other children would abandon them and even forbid them from talking and touching them. Even at the school, she was being avoided by all teachers in all activities. This did not matter anyway because she was pulled out of the school and married off at the age of 12 when she was in the 7th standard. Marriage did not do any good either. This 12-year-old child was responsible for all the cooking, cleaning, laundry for a family of 10 people. She was starved and abused brutally. Later, when her father came to see her, he took her away. After she returned, she was determined to earn a job. So she applied for many kinds of jobs like nursing, military, constable and etc. but got rejected either because of her age or her education. At last, she learned tailoring skills and earned 10 rupees per blouse piece. After doing this for a few days, she thought dying was easier than living. She lost hope in her life and drank a bottle of poison. While she was drinking poison, her aunt saw her and her family rushed her to the hospital. She didn't think she was going to live for the amount of poison she drank, but she lived. She seized this chance and thought this was her second chance to live. She felt empowered and strong. After that, she convinced her parents and moved to Mumbai, where she did tailoring as a full-time job. She was the only earning member in the family, so she started working for 16 hours a day. After that, she went through various schemes and applied for a loan. With that, she started selling furniture. She did not stop tailoring either. Her condition slowly started improving. She even started an NGO where she shared her knowledge in government schemes and loans for people like her. And after 2 years, she paid her initial loan. After that, she joined Kamini Cubes and continued the hard work there. After the death of the owner and due to a few disputes inside the company, she was chosen as the next chairperson by the employees themselves. After that, she constructs the company slowly, overcame all problems, and now the company is worth $112 million. She was awarded Padma Shri in 2013 for all her hard work, which she totally deserves. She is dubbed as the original Slumdog Millionaire by many. Her story is totally inspiring. I think you also found it inspiring too. Thank you.